my torque wrench decided to show its face later on, so I can just finish off torquing these. . 13 to 15 is the foot pounds is the torque setting, so I've set this to 14. That seems pretty tight. So my original settings, just by guesswork, were not really that far off. Well, it's all happening today. Airplanes, springtime, so the lambs next door. And don't forget the two side bolts, just a nip, a final nip on those. And if you've got one of these 12 volt bikes and you're wondering, is there something missing there? No, that's from the 6 volt bikes, from either the electronic ignition or the points. There's a bracket what bolts on there to hold the wire, the cable in place. That's all. If it really upsets you, screw a fastener in it. I know yesterday I said I was in a rush, I wanted to hear the engine running, and I didn't set the tappets, the valve clearances. Once I'd fitted the air cleaner, quieting down the induction noise, you could then easily hear the characteristic tap tap tapping sound of loose tappets, excessive valve clearances. Valve clearances on these Hondas are set with the engine cold, but I'll start the engine just quickly, just so you can hear and know what the difference between a cam chain rattle and the tapping sound of loose valve clearances. Can you hear that characteristic tap tap tapping sound? That's loose or excessive valve clearances. For the engine to cool, I decided to change the O-rings in the inspection caps. You can see they lose their shape, and look at this, how brittle this one is. Simple job, change the two O-rings in the two caps. Adjusting the valve clearances, or commonly called the tappets, is easier to do. It's probably harder to film than it is to do, because you can't see with my hands in the way. If you've never done this before, I'd suggest you take the covers off the casings on the other side, turn the engine over until you get it onto top dead center on compression. So I've taken the spark plug out, so look, you can feel the compression there, so we know that we're coming up to compression, top dead center on the compression stroke. Now obviously, if you've done this quite a few times, you'll be able to do it by feel, you won't need to do that. What we need is the camshaft in the position that it's not pressing on the rockers. And if you can see there, try and do it with my hand out the way, small amount of play, and we need to adjust the adjuster there to give us 0.02 of an inch or 0.02 of clearance. Now you can use to hold this, you can buy a special tool, you can use a pair of pliers or a small shifter if you wish. What I've done, I've just got a wood screw. You can use a Robertson screw, that's exactly the right fit for the top of the valve. And you can use that. I've put a bend in it, little tiny handle on there, and then with it's an odd size, it's 9mm, so with a 9mm ring spanner and your tool, tool, homemade tool, you can easily set it. Now it's easier to open it up wide and start again. So till you can just feel a slight drag on there. So what we need to do, hold it in place and lock up the lock nut. And that's that one done. That's the inlet valve. The exhaust valve, exactly the same. It's just a bit more awkward to film underneath. That's both the inlet valve and the exhaust valve clearances set. Let's start the engine. See if the tapping noise has gone. And I think you'll agree. Tapping noise is gone, the engine sounds much better. Happy days.